Welcome everyone to the new era of AI accelerator cards for the PC. Hey everyone, Mark Hockman here from PCWorld here at CES 2024, where we're looking at something we hope is going to be special, the first era of AI acceleration cards for the PC. We're here in Lenovo's booth, and we're looking at the Lenovo ThinkPad Neo Ultra. This is a standalone desktop. It's going to be about $1,000 shipping in June. But what's interesting here is that they're showing the first PCI Express-based AI accelerator cards. And there's actually two. The first, which we're going to be showcasing, is MemoryX. And the second over here is by a company called Kinara. Now, what is an AI accelerator card? We know that we have processors out there from both AMD and Intel, which have NPUs, which are AI accelerators. However, there's really nothing shipping or available right now for the desktop. That's where startups are stepping in. This is the MemoryX, and inside here is what's called the MemoryX MX3. It's a PCI Express card, an M.2 form factor. It has four chips, each of them, again, the MX3, and each chip can perform about 10 teraflops of AI processing power. Now, that may not mean a lot to you, it doesn't mean a lot to us right now, but what Intel and Qualcomm and AMD are talking about are in that same neighborhood, 40 to 50 or 60 teraflops, or tops, I should say. This company is talking about is teraflops. It's a bit more sophisticated. Honestly, we really don't know in terms of benchmarking how the performance is gonna pan out. But what we can tell you is how it's being used. This is being used primarily as a vision processor. And up here we see that this is in fact interpreting our cameraman Willis. He is actually, you can see the avatar here, physically holding, well, there would be a camera showcasing here, but physically holding that camera. And that is going to be, well, one of the applications that AI is being used for. The others would be local language models, large language models running on the PC, chatbots in other words, potentially gaming. You can see a little bit about how everything is being used. The NPU is on, the GPU is primarily being used, the CPU is being used as well. But again, the NPU is going to be stepping in and taking over here. If you'd like more detail though, please go to PCWorld.com and sort of read the details about what this chip offers. We don't know so much about Kinara over on the other end, but again, it's a competitor. The point that we're trying to make though is that there are a number of these guys floating out there. Lenovo has told us that there is about 8, 10, perhaps even a dozen PC or card vendors, each vying to be sort of the next rendition or 3DFX, what those guys were to 3D graphics, what these guys are hoping to be for AI technology. Now again, very early days of AI. We don't know how this is going to pan out. We don't know exactly how the tops are going to pan out. Again, the performance is relatively low, but again, once Moore's Law gets in the equation, we start scaling and scaling and scaling. We have applications taking advantage of this. We start seeing things that are a little bit more interesting. Remember the early days of rendition and 3DFX, that early days of Tomb Raider, Lara Croft. You know, it wasn't too far away that we had Jurassic Park. Maybe we get into that situation in a few years. But again, we are on the cusp of hopefully what is a new era of AI cards from both MemoryX and Kinara. I'm Mark Hockman. Keep it tuned to PC World's YouTube channel, and please visit PCWorld.com for the detailed specs on these new chips.